Good morning, everyone. CB Repair Guy here. We're going to do a video this morning on a radio that I think is pretty neat. It's built like a tank, and it's got some potential. It's called a President Bill FCC, which means it's a 40-channel CB radio. And what you're looking at there is the box that basically it comes in. And we're going to take you through this radio, show you the power output that it does and the receive, how sensitive it is, and a few of the cool features it's got, and maybe talk about a couple of applications where it might fit in really well for you. So when I come back, I'll have the radio out here and we'll get started. All right, we're back, and we've got the radio setting up here, as you can see, and I'm going to do this around the camera, so hopefully you can tell. You see the front, this is all cast aluminum, except your bottom lid right here, which is plastic. Small speaker fits here. SO239 external speaker jack goes here. Microphone, of course, which is a 6-pin, by the way. Not a big deal. You can put a noise canceling mic on it if you choose. Actually, whatever mic you choose. It does have a USB port here. This port is for nothing more than like charging your phone, stuff like that. It gives you, I believe, a 2.1 amp. It's 5 volts, 2.1 amp output there. You have one knob here for your volume. Your next knob behind it is your squelch. And then some buttons on each side that do different functions, which is kind of cool. Let's see if I can bring this up here. Hopefully it's going to maybe focus. As we look here on our left, this button is going to be our noise blanker. It's going to be our noise limiting function, noise blanker, and a high cut filter, which the high cut filter is really nice to get rid of some of that hissy kind of noise that we hear, that white noise, that hissy noise. Does have a Roger beep and a lock button that locks everything so you can't change anything when you hold that in. We come over here, we have our CB and weather alert. It does have weather in it, which is really nice. It has the emergency channel, channel 9, of course, and then it's also 19 is programmed, so you have two emergency channels, which I believe you can program to whatever channels you would like. Channel display here. One of the cool features, and I'll show you, let's go ahead and turn it on. Okay. And that's set on green color right now. I don't know if you can tell that with the camera. But if we want to change channels, you notice there's no channel knob here. We do have in the microphone up and down that we can use. However, look at this. You push down right here on your channel display and it rocks. And it changes your frequency. It's pretty awesome, I think. So that's basically the, and there's your emergencies, 19 and 9, and then back to 20. Your weather alert. Then you've got your different weather stations that you can set there from your weather alert. Roger beep turns it on. If we hold it long enough, we go into lock. I can no longer change frequency. Get it out of that. Then our noise filters. High cut. There we go. All right, so you can see basically, it's very simple to use. This thing is very, very, very small. I mean, if we look in my hand, you can see it's very small. What I want to do now is I'm going to take you inside the radio. We're going to pull the covers. We'll show you what's inside. I'll let you see what's going on there. And we'll talk about that a little bit. And then we'll actually hook this thing up and do some testing.
Okay, we're back. And
be right back. All I can say is welcome to the land of small. This radio is just everything about it is small. So let's go over a few features here, and I don't know if how well this is going to zoom. We're going to try it and see what happens. If we can zoom in. Yeah, We zoomed in. This is our driver. It's our final MOSFET. What is that, the FQP or FPQ or whatever it is. That's pretty good power for a single final radio. As a matter of fact, it'll should do about what a Cobra 29 does any day of the week. As you can see right through here, what this is these are shielded, but this is your outputs. You can see your coils. I don't know if you can see them. They're back in behind there, but each, it's all your output coils, your tuning network, basically, for the radio's output. You come out here, your last coil, that's probably your 54 megahertz, and then up in here is where your antenna is, and it goes through and basically goes out to your radio there. You have computer-grade SMD caps here. This is your main capacitor coming in, your filter cap coming in. Crystal, your 10240, 455 kilohertz filter. A lot of stuff is on the back side of this board. I took this board out. I took the liberty to take this thing apart earlier. I won't bore you with all that, but it does come out really easy. You have one ribbon cable right here to contend with. This cable connects the front of the radio to basically the main board. Two wires, you unplug this connector, and essentially a lot of screws to keep things put down there and into the aluminum heatsink well, and basically the board pops right out. And it wasn't hard. Now it's going to be, you know, service is going to be an issue. Some will say, oh, you can't service it, but you can. It certainly is serviceable. It takes probably less than 3 or 4 minutes to pull this board out, and you've got the board in your hand. You can do whatever it is you need to do. Won't be too big of a deal. So while we've got it apart, one thing that I do want to talk about, and I don't know if you noticed, there's absolutely no controls here. There is no adjustments in this radio whatsoever. Everything is done through software. There is no wattage setting, modulation setting, any of that stuff is done. Frequency, all that is done through software controls. It's been preset. There is a menu that you can get into to actually set some of those things, which we won't be doing that today, but there is a service menu that you can get into, which gives you a little bit of leeway in what you can do. What I want to do is show you this radio as a, out of the box, and show you how well it's put together, and show you what kind of wattage and things it does, and we'll go from there with it. So give me a minute, we'll fire this thing up, we'll get her on the air, I'll show you some watt meter readings on it, and we'll show you an oscilloscope picture of it, and we'll just go from there. I'll be right back, guys. Okay, we're back, and let's get this thing fired up and see what it does. So we're going to go ahead and turn it on. We're on channel 20, by the way. Let me see if I can. We've got it upside down. Let's see if we can turn it right side up. What a mess. Power cord's in the way. We'll get it. Maybe. Okay, there we go. Now, one thing that I will talk about here is this is the power cord does not disconnect. It is one solid soldered in piece. It does have a fuse on it. We're running it connected here, and what I've done is I've run it up to my, let's see if I can get the picture, where am I, right here, we're running it on this power supply, oops, which you can see our voltage, we're running 14 volts, I've got it set at 4 amps, so down here is our what we're going to be drawing. So when we key it, when we key the radio, which I'm going to do now, we're drawing 1.5 amps at 14 volts, okay? And I use this, that way it limits the current if anything was to happen. You know, if we've got wires exposed around here, we wouldn't short things out and blow things up, so that's what we're doing. So we're going to go from there, and what I want to do is get you over to the watt meter. So here we go. Hold on, don't get seasick. I got to find the watt meter. Merciful heavens. We do have a watt meter somewhere. There it is. And there we go. Sorry. Never said I was a cameraman. Okay, we're using this MFJ giant watt meter. Before you guys start puking and going carrying on, it works really well. I don't have any problem with it. I've got a bird, but I can see this better, so that's why we're using it today. So we're going to key the radio. And as you can see, we've got a 3-watt dead key. Now we're going to just do a little modulation into it and see. We are on PEP, by the way. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to go up to a 200-watt scale, which is your center scale there on the meter. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. You can see there we're bouncing around 20 watt scale. Not a problem with that. Let me come back and we'll go over here to the oscilloscope. Right here. There we go. And we'll do the same thing. We'll talk 1, 2, 3, 4. As you can see, the modulation limiter has not been clipped. We're just talking along. Everything's fine. I just wanted you to hear it so you would see how it sounded there. Now, what I am going to do, I'm going to do something a little unorthodox that some guys probably won't do, but I'm going to turn the radio on above me. It's on 20 as well. Let's see if we can hear. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let me turn it up a little bit so you can hear it a little better. 1, 2, 3, 4. Audio test. Audio test. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Audio. Hello. Audio test. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you can hear how it sounds. As far as frequency goes, out of the box, I'm showing 27.2. Yeah. 27.20493. Let me go here to the spectrum analyzer. Let's see it. Peak. Drag the radio all the way across the table. I'll take you up to the spectrum analyzer. I think I'm going to have to move you to get you there. Bear with me, guys. Hopefully you'll be able to see this. Let's see if I can bring this in a little closer. That's what we're looking at there. And you can see both sides. Hello, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Audio, that's set at 10 kilohertz division. And you can see it there for yourself to see. At 10 kilohertz division, we're looking actually pretty good signal. That's not bad at all. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Audio test. Audio test. You see both sides, upper and lower. Everything looks pretty good there. Like I said, we're stock out of the box, so we shouldn't be getting too crazy as far as signals go. Alright, so we've kind of went over transmit. We're seeing 20-ish watts, which is fair. I think that's not too bad for a radio that size. What we want to do now is we're going to go ahead and set it up and do the receive test. We'll see how sensitive the receiver is. I'll be right back. Okay, we're back, and what we've got going on here is we've changed our coax and our external speaker for our radio. We're going to send that right into, let's see if I can get this where you can see it. Hey, we're going to get on with the program of testing the receive of this. Right now we've got our machine hooked up to it. Excuse me, and that obnoxious tone you hear is a 1,000 hertz tone being injected into the radio right now. Squelch is wide open. We're ready to go. Pardon me. Let's go over here and take a look at our machine. See where we're at. Okay. By the way, this is I can't pronounce, Schlumberger, I believe it is, an SI-4031. Stay block. It's a great piece of test equipment. We're going to test right now the sensitivity of the receiver. You see we're on 27205. We've got a negative 73 dBm signal injected, which is an S9 signal. We down here and we look at our SYNAD and we're looking at 38.5, which is very sensitive. We're going to see what it does on our sensitivity test. So we're going to hit this button. It's going to take us into our test mode. Down below you can see there we're at 12 dB. That's our sensitivity cutoff. This will automatically run a test and tell us where we are. A negative 115.4 dBm. Guys, that's phenomenal as far as negative 115 dBm is really good as far as being able to hear. I'll go ahead and turn that noise off. That's a sensitive radio. Nothing to be ashamed about there as far as hearing. Let's see if I can get this thing back where we were. So, what's the bottom line with something like this? You know, it's a little radio. It doesn't have all the bells and whistles like some of the big ones. It's not a 100-watt radio. You think, well, what on earth can we do with it, or what? Why would you want it? Well, I'll tell you. If you think about it, this radio measures, let me see here and I'll tell you, the width of this radio is about 4 inches wide. The length of the radio, well, it's actually about a 4x4 square, okay? So you've got something that essentially fits in a palm of your hand. You could mount that in a UTV, in a boat, on an ATV. You Jeep guys, this would be an awesome little radio to put in there in for your Jeep, for four-wheeling. You could put a little amplifier with it if you needed. One of those little KLV amps, or you know, something, a little one-pill Texas Star Mod V, if you wanted to put something in there like that, you could. But the point being, this would fit in a lot of new cars. It's going to fit somewhere inconspicuously and give you a decent output, great receive, in a nice small package. So I really believe it's a great bang for the buck. The other thing is, it's not going to set your wallet back, you know, $500. You're talking about, what, 130-ish, somewhere in there probably. Don't hold me to that, but that's close. To get you in a nice little radio. You can charge your cell phone with it if you need to. As far as that goes, even if you went camping, something like that, you could throw in your backpack. Be kind of neat. Put it in your camper. Something like that would be great to put in a camper, your motorhome. I mean, there's just the list goes on for the size of it and the quality of the build. The next thing, you know, you're not invested. Somebody going to steal that? Well, they might, but half the time they probably wouldn't even see it. So it helps versus having something big and gaudy stuck in there where in a vehicle that you don't use very often. Just some thoughts. I don't know what you guys think about it, but I was pretty impressed. President does have a great warranty. President is one of the companies that is working with us as far as getting us product information and literature and some of the things that some of the rest of these guys have stopped doing. You know, the lines of communication are open at President. If I need to call them, I can call down and talk to them. If I have a service question, I can call down and talk to them. Unfortunately, a lot of our other radio manufacturers or importers have stopped those lines of communication. So I want to try to support a company that wants to support us. And I think that President right now is probably on top of the game as far as doing that. So we're going to do some more videos on some of their other radios coming out. They've got some pretty cool radios coming out. I believe the Richard is one of the newest ones. I think it's going to be a real hit 10-meter radio. That should be out very, very soon, so be looking forward to seeing that. Oh, and just before you guys ask, no, I'm not being compensated for President. I'm just saying from a repair guy's point of view, being able to talk and get service information and get technical help when you need it is imperative. These other guys have dropped the ball on that. A lot of them are trying to go to Amazon and sell, and they're just trying to leave the dealer out in the cold. Well, you know, us dealers have worked a long time on their products, and you know, in my world, I fixed a lot of radios that I should have sent back for warranty and just ate it out of my pocket to make the customer happy. You're not going to get that from Amazon when you buy. So it's just some things to think about. I've rambled way too long. I'm sure that I'll catch grief over that for talking so much, guys. But good to be back on the videos. You're going to see a lot more videos coming. I know I've said that before, but I've decided whether I make them with shaky camera or not, I'm going to make them. I want to get some information out there to you guys. So, hey, if you have any questions, hit me up. You know, sometimes I'm slow to get back to you. I'm just a one-man show here, just working at my own pace. I'm not 21 anymore, so. But if you have questions, hit me up. I'll try to answer them as quick as I can. If you need anything, our website is www.customcbradios.com. Be happy if you could order some or decided to buy something that you'd at least give us a look-see. Other than that, guys, it's been great, and we will talk to you soon. Y'all have a wonderful day. Take care.